Hondurans have taken advantage of independence celebrations to step up their campaign for the resignation of President Juan Orlando Hernandez. Gerardo Torres has more from Tegucigalpa.
As Central America commemorates its 194th anniversary of independence from Spain, protesters took to the streets in Honduras. They wanted to point out that independence is still something they are fighting for because of the continuing interference of the United States in their country's military, political, and economic decisions.
The government tries to sell us the idea that this is an independent country, but in fact, we depend economically and politically on the foreign policy, especially of the United States. There are many examples, including the exploitation of our maritime resources, extensive mining, and so on. There is no independence, so we are trying to promote a new way of understanding this.
The government had its official parade with the participation of the military forces and members of the ruling National Party.
In the first place, I come here because I wanted to, not because they paid me, and here you can see the people that truly want independence for Honduras.
The leader of the resistance movement and former President Manuel Zelaya didn't take part in the protest for medical reasons.
Manuel Zelaya Rosales today had an operation for a fracture in his thigh bone, and he had to miss this protest, but he sent a message and asked me to read it to all the protesters. He is in an excellent condition. There is no danger. He just didn't want to postpone this operation any longer, and he soon will be back in the country.
As they have done for the last 4 months, the protesters demanded the resignation of president and punishment for those public officials who are accused of corruption. Gerardo Torres, Telesur, Central America.